Hi, today I'm going to show you how to set your kerf value. It's important to know that the kerf value is not just the thickness of the blade, but it's how much material is being removed every time you cut a piece of material. It's necessary for the TigerStop to know what the kerf value is based off of running a pusher list, incremental mode, or running a optimized set point list. So here's how we check it. First, we're going to grab a scrap piece of material, and then we're going to set the TigerStop within the range of whatever our caliper can handle. In this case, my calipers can only go 8 inches. So we're going to make a cut at 7 inches. So we'll hit 7 and start. Make our cut. And then we'll take our caliper and get a reading. Okay, so here we are right on 7 inches. So now that we have that, we're gonna go ahead and write that value down. We'll just write it on the material. And we're going to cut this piece just roughly in half. Now that we have these two pieces, we're going to nest them together, and that's going to let us know exactly how much material has been removed. So we'll take the calipers with both pieces of material securely butt up next to each other. And I can see it is 6.876. So we'll write that down. Now, using the TigerStop's calculator function, we're going to take our first value of the full piece, 7, and we're going to subtract our two pieces that were nested together, 6.876, hit equals, and we can see our value is 0.124. So we'll write that down. And now we're going to change this to our new kerf value. So to do that, we'll need to select D for show, and then A for menu. It's going to ask us for a password. So the password is generally going to be your serial number. That can be located on the opposite end of the motor box on the front face of the extrusion. So right here, looks like the password is 1527331. So we'll go ahead and enter that in. 1527331. And we'll hit equals to confirm. And now we're going to select A for setup. And then we'll use the arrow buttons to scroll through until we find kerf. Okay, we can see our kerf is set at 0.142. So we're going to change it to our new value that we've just come up with, 0.124. And once again, we're going to use the equals button to confirm. We'll just double check that that value has changed and hit done. All right, guys, so that's how you set your kerf.